Hello everyone. Today there'll be the four of us, me, Peter, Jasper, say hi.
Hi.
Sheng Jie, Paul Kai, and Chiro. We'll be doing a presentation on intercultural communication based on age and mostly on age, like the age difference and the generation gaps. So of course this is your starter slide, everyone knows. So cultural identity, what is this? So today we'll be focusing mostly on age and life stages. So age gaps. 40 years old, fresh grads, 50, 60, that kind of thing. Okay, our case study is an interesting one. It came up pretty recently. It is on this person called Talia Jane. Has anyone heard of her? On medium.com. Okay, for those of you who don't know her, she is this person who has a degree. If I'm not wrong, it's an English degree.
Yes.
So, she has an English degree from a reputable university, but she chose to go to Yale as a what's that called? As a minimum wage worker. So she wasn't happy with management, she wasn't happy with a few things, so she, instead of going to the CEO, she went to write an open letter on the internet, which was a pretty bad idea. But I won't be saying that, I want to be more on the internet. So Tyler Jane, 35-year-old English literature major, so quite close to our age, joined Yale as a representative, you can read that. Bay Area is expensive, it's really expensive. A house, a rental apartment, a small one is like $2,000-$3,000. It's really expensive. And of course, as a minimum wage worker, it's kind of hard to earn that much to pay your rent. Stephanie Williams is 4 years a senior, but you'll hear more about her later as well. So the more important question I have to ask you guys before we carry on is this: where do we fit in? All of us are going to graduate someday. Some of us in this coming semester. Some next year, like 2 semesters away, I am going to graduate next year. Everyone always tells us, oh, you're a fresh grad. Oh, you're special. In secondary school, you are great. You are smart. You are hardworking. You are all the good things. But when you come out to the world, you're just average. Unless you have connections, like your father's a rich man or he owns an oil company. It's pretty hard because you're just a fresh face in the world, you're just a nobody, myself included. So the question is, how do we fit in? And of course, first impressions, they always matter. Okay, so let me share with you a story from my time in Switzerland when I was working there. Interesting place, I was the only Asian in the office. So everyone else was taller than me, everyone else spoke something else I never understood. But more importantly, their work ethic, their culture, is very different. What in Singapore, usually when I was working in Singapore, right, what they ask you is, if you don't know how to do it, go Google. Just go Google. You will know one. But over there, it's different. Over there, if you don't know it, you need to ask me. You have to ask. Which was surprising because I thought they would just tell you to just go to Google or YouTube and just do it. So that was one of the first impressions I got from there. So I don't think they had a very good impression of me as Asian, Yeah, so that's just one example. And the way they work is very different. They work as a team, it's very informal. The boss, we all speak with first names. We don't use Mr. This, Miss That. So that's very different. So that's for first impressions. And for fresh grad, well, we have to distinguish ourselves. But for the next point, I will ask Jasper to do it. He's better. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi everyone. I'll be talking about the power of language and words. Basically, to summarize a little bit more on this article itself, Talia Jin wrote on an open blog post, specifically on Medium, and this blog post was directed to her CEO at Yale, which is Jeremy Sokolan. Was she being a bit too informal regarding the topics that she talked about? For example, minimum wages. Not having enough money to support herself, even though she's working. For example, she was using rhetorical comments to comment on the low pay of the employees, and might I say that her comments were not kind, very not kind, even if she was looking for assistance. By the way, she actually accepted handouts from other people out of the company. One example is that she actually received money to take the the bus transport, or rather the train, to go to work. And whereas this lady here, Stephanie Williams, who is 4 years older, also with an English major, she came out to the workplace around her age, and she'd been there, done that, whatever that Talia Jin has gone through. She took a very different approach. Well, when she made an official reply back on Business Insider, that, you know, Stephanie Williams also used a style of informal writing, though her choice of words were less extreme. For one, she was not hostile with her words. Let me quote both of them and show you an example. This is how Talia Jin actually introduced herself and write to Jeremy for her boss on her blog site. When I was a kid back in the 90s, when Spice Girls was owning a pager were the dreams. I dreamed of having a car and credit card and my own apartment. I told my 8-year-old self, this is what it means to be adult. Whereas for Stephanie Williams, dear Talia Ji, after reading your article detailing the absolute struggle you dealt with working for a Bay Area-based corporation, I felt it imperative to address your concerns and, above all, your obvious need for financial assistance. Look at the way these two people actually phrase the first sentence, while both of them appeared on the net. It's very different. It's how Talia Jin made herself look like in front of the net, especially when this was a cry for help. The next example, look, I'll make you a deal. You don't have to pay my phone bill. I just have to disconnect my phone. I'll disconnect my home internet, and so on and so forth. She was using pretty sarcastic remarks by a lot of standards. For my standards, especially, she was using very, very sarcastic remarks to actually ask for help and address an issue about low wage and not having enough money. Stephanie Williams replies that, you know, being an English major isn't a problem. Minimum wage isn't a problem, especially for her case. She doesn't really like CEOs who are young and rich too. But the way she phrased it, it wasn't as harsh. And at the same time, it was addressing to an issue that wasn't really said. It was just a choice of words. If you were asking for help, would you have used Talia Jane's tone, or would you have used Stephanie Williams' tone? Then the question would be, would Talia Jane's position change if she wrote to a CEO formally instead? For example, when we took on this module, I remember the first lesson we talked about having the right type of documentation when we are speaking to our subordinates or even to our bosses. If Talia Jane wrote an official letter, it would be very different. Yeah. And this was quoted by Stephanie Williams. Despite our less than a decade difference in age, it seems that we are worlds apart in the concept of work ethics. But somehow I'm not surprised, those 5 little years are incredibly important. Yes, it is very important because it really differentiates how we speak to our bosses and how we present ourselves to everyone else. Yeah. I'll pass on the presentation to the next speaker, Hashiro.
She hasn't been there for very long, but she realized that every week the business changes. So it actually means that there's a management problem within the organization itself, where employers are not being valued very much. Okay. Then the second point that she mentioned was about the compensation structure. What she mentioned was that each and every colleague that she had, they were struggling to meet the end needs, and they are practically every one of them are taking part-time jobs outside. Yeah. So she's not really happy with this new structure in the company. So what are the implications of X, right? Is that firstly it will decrease the organization performance in a sense that the morale of the company, the workers will be low because people are affected by the spreading of this blog post, because apparently it was quite popular after she posted it. Within the 2 hours, it was shared through the blog. Yeah. So the second thing is that it will affect the company image in the sense that the reputation will be tarnished as the mass media will start to spread about it, report about it, and later it will just portray Yelp as a company that has poor management and without welfare to their employees. And the last thing is financial losses, because a lot of investors and stakeholders, right, they wouldn't want to form partnership with companies that are slammed with this kind of poor employee treatment, so they will try to withdraw from any partnership from there. So with this in mind, our group actually come up with an alternative method that she could have adopted in raising her concerns to the higher management. So the first one would be face-to-face. Well, face-to-face, the benefit of face-to-face is that you can observe the other party's emotion, body language, and her tone. So I think it's more effective to say that you can express your helplessness and your desperation to your supervisor. So the supervisor will be able to view it in how to play through your body languages and your tone. So I think this is the most effective method. So secondly, she could have written an email which could link to different parties, CC to different parties of concern, such as the supervisor, the HR, which could raise the issue internally and not externally out in the post. And other methods will include employees holding a meeting, maybe during staff lunch or even during meals. She could approach the higher level authority to voice the concerns. Okay, so now I hand over the time to Shen Jie, who will bring you through the intercultural differences, and subsequently will bring up our presentation.
Thank you, Shirong. Now I'll be covering about the intercultural differences between the two parties that were mentioned. So Stephanie and Talia were only 5 years apart in age, yet there was a huge difference in their mentality and attitude towards working. So is this an issue of entitlement versus privilege? Clearly, we can see that in Talia's case, she thought that holding a job would entitle her to have to pay off her rent, not be in debt, own a car, and being able to afford good food. While for Stephanie Williams, she clearly doesn't think so. She thinks that you need to put in hard work to actually achieve all these tangible assets. So this leads us to think whether the reality lives up to his expectations. So for Talia, she thought that having a car, a credit card, and her own apartment is what it means to be an adult. But sadly, she learned the harsh truth that having all these tangible assets were actually symbols of stress and not success. So her idea of having a job will guarantee you to such tangible assets were actually her source of distress, as seeing that she constantly complained about having to share an apartment to lighten the burden of the rent, and also not being able to afford to pay off to fix a car. And lastly, what are the differences in their approach to solving their problems? So Talia actually wrote a blog post to openly complain about all the unfair treatments and working conditions. wow, actually she posted pictures of her sipping expensive alcohol on her Instagram. Pretty ironic, right? So in her rebuttal, in Stephanie's rebuttal, she actually said that Kylie Jenner actually asked for handouts from strangers and think that all this is more acceptable than taking up a job in a restaurant or coffee shop, which usually people think that these are less reputable jobs. So you may be thinking, what is the relevance? What is this case relevant to us? At some point of time, we will definitely be job hunting and looking for a career. So we need to bring in this correct mindset and working attitude to our workplace. While it is not wrong for us to be ambitious and dream big, we must still bear in mind that people do not owe us a living. In order to achieve all these ambitions, we need to put in hard work to actually attain it. And the language is a powerful tool to actually build rapport. And in many cases, we want to prevent misunderstandings between people by clearly stating our intentions when sending our message across. And lastly, we must be responsible when posting information on our personal social media website. So what seems to be a harmless message may actually turn out to harm the reputation of all the parties that were involved. And lastly, to conclude our whole presentation, firstly, we mentioned that the power of language is not to be underestimated. So when used effectively, we can actually use language to our advantage and build rapport between our colleagues. However, when we use it ineffectively, it may cause unnecessary misunderstandings and even conflicts among our people. And we also have to take note that the tone and formality when addressing the issues will also largely affect people's perspective. So next, we also have to take note of the proper and ethical communication channels when we are trying to bring across our messages. So we do not want people to misunderstand our messages and hurt their reputation. And lastly, we have to understand these intercultural differences so that when we offer our opinion to others, we do not actually offend them. And with this, we have come to the end of our presentation. So we will now open the floor to questions.
Medium is actually a kind of like our blog spot, so it's actually open to everyone. And yes, I do agree that the freedom of speech do play a part. Both Talia Jin and Stephanie Williams are based in America, which I would have to say both have the same amount of freedom of speech. It's just how you use this freedom of speech to actually bring out a point. For example, Would you raise a concern about low wages or even not having enough food on the table on a blog post to your boss, or rather on an official email saying you are facing a lot of problems to your boss?
Well, at the very least, talk to him.
Yeah.
Like face to face, it's a lot better, right? Wait, does that answer your question?
Sorry. If you're the company, how could you prevent the failure?
How would I prevent the
This is a tricky one because you can't prevent someone from being like that. Okay, backstory a bit. American education system, right? Okay, if I'm wrong, please correct me. They are raised based on the idea that if you go to college, it's like a bit like us. It means you will have a degree.
Have a degree means have a good job. Have a good job means have a good life. You know the how the story goes, right? So it might be the case that she thinks that way. She may be one of the few people who thought that way and was vocal enough to start saying this on medium.com. So to ask how you can prevent an added Talia J, you could change the education system. You could. Or
proper training.
Yes, proper training, but then again it doesn't remove the entitlement mentality sometimes, right? So sometimes people like that, we have to learn the hard way. So you can't exactly prevent it. You can curb it though, but you can't prevent it.
My add on your point is that I understood this point, this principle, and I actually kept by it. Every choice has a consequence. And you learn every mistake through a lesson. And this is the problem. You don't really have to go through the thing yourself. Someone like Talia Jin, and I'm sure there's a lot before Talia Jin who did this, and actually, you know, there's so much of these cases on the net. We can actually learn from them instead of going through this issue on our own. I wouldn't want to be on the net getting flamed all over because of maybe supposedly a not so mature comment. Yeah. Anybody else?
Sorry, may I clarify? Your topic is about intercultural communication. Yes. So your two different cultures that you're comparing is actually the 29-year-old.
The age.
So you're assuming that the 29-year-old is a certain culture,
mm-hmm.
and then the 25-year-old is another different culture. And you're comparing the two together,
yes,
is it? Because our usual thinking of intercultural,
mm-hmm.
is like more of a,
yes,
of
course,
geometrical boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of, so
the reason why we did this, Okay, the reason why we chose a 25 and a 29-year-old is simply put, right? If you have worked a few years, you will know that nothing comes for free. It's a life-changing sort of mindset. Like if you work a while, you know that no one's going to give you handouts unless you're part of it. But that's just the point. You know that what you got, you worked for. You won't be like a fresh grad, oh, look, I have a degree, employ me, give me money. Some people think like that.
I think the whole point about this is that intercultural communication not just transcends between physical boundaries, but it also transcends between each group. A mere short 5 years, or might be even lesser, can be seen right in this case, and even within our society. For example, if you are going to speak to a secondary school student about some issues, I don't think they will understand what you're speaking about. Only when they reach this stage where you are, probably they will understand a little bit more, but not yet exactly the same what kind of point you're trying to bring across. Yeah.
Okay, any other questions?
Yes.
Why did Talia James vote for minimum wages?
That's a very good question. That's what we all wanted to do, but she did not disclose that information.
Stephanie Williams actually asked her, why are you working for minimum? Why are you working at minimum wage? And then I think she replied. So.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Just a question for your opinion. Do you think that Stephanie did the right thing by also openly replying to her and so-called rebut her statement and all? I think there's no right or wrong, it's just very obvious.
Oh, I think Stephanie she did the right thing. Because basically the formality that she used is totally different from what Tanya did. She was more formal, and she did not really talk bad about a company just based on her own perspective. But she, she used her own perspective to counter her back. In the sense that, she did not defame the company. But from her point of view, she tried to help the company, you know, to fight for the company. Yeah. So I think she did right this.
Okay, any other questions? Thank you very much.
Last question. You guys compared Talia James and Stephanie to 5 and 9 year old. So the thing is, the way I see it, I somehow don't feel that it's the problem of intercultural communication, but it's a problem of maturity.
Maturity.
Because I feel that Talia James is not sure to be in the communication. Sorry?
Okay. Prior to this article being posted, Talia Jin actually was using, if I remember correctly, was using Twitter to try and communicate with her CEO. And you know, there was a couple of posts saying, you know, I know you're gonna ignore me, but I'm still gonna follow you, and I'm gonna, you know, learn more about you just to make friends, and you know, and things like this. It's not just about age gap. It's not just about maturity. Look at our own society for now. How many of us create a Facebook account before we actually do something, you know, proper? Like, would you create a Facebook account for corporate use and then a personal Facebook account? I don't think most of us go to that extent. But the difference in culture, like whether we are going more tech or we are even being more face-to-face and formal, it's almost the same as the last group who actually used Japan and Americans. We are blowing, like not blowing it up, but actually looking at a more specific case within a country right now. The cultural difference is that, you know, it's very different if I am 24 and there's another guy who's 20.
Yeah.
Yeah. The way we actually choose to communicate, even with to our bosses, to our teachers, is very different. Yeah.
Okay, any other questions?
I only said
last question.
Okay, okay. Can.
Thank you.
Never mind. It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.